guys, Julia, and welcome back to my channel. And for today's video, I'm going to be doing my August wrap-up, talking about all the books that I read in the month of August. So the first book that I read this month was Confessions of a Sociopath by M.E. Thomas, and I'm going to put this down because it ruins the lighting. This book is about a self-diagnosed sociopath. It's a non-fiction book, and it's about how she hides in plain sight, and all we know is that she identified as female, and she self-diagnosed herself as a sociopath and later gets an official diagnosis. This book, I read 30 pages of it, and I could not do it. And I started skimming after that. It was horrible. It made me like need to take breaks, like to breathe and to like process how upset I was getting over it. It was infuriating me. And she also compares the sociopathic spectrum to the autistic spectrum, which pisses me off. And she was just horrible and I hated her. So I gave this book 1 star. And I would not recommend it. The next book that I read this month was The Girl Who Loved Tom Gordon by Stephen King. It's about a 9-year-old girl who gets lost in the woods, and it's about her surviving in there and just all the things that happened with her family and how she's coping with everything. She's also in love with this baseball player named Tom Gordon, and it's about how baseball kind of intertwines in this plot, and it's actually really interesting. I kind of like the references, but if you are a baseball fan, it's gonna make it extra special for you. This was more simplistic than King's other work. I have a full-length video book review of this on my channel, so I'll have it linked up on the screen and in the description box for you guys to check out if you want to hear more of my thoughts. Basically, at first I gave this book a 3.25 out of 5 stars, and though I really enjoyed reading it and it really was just, I was really enthralled in the story, it wasn't as complex, and in a way it was good, but it was kind of different from King, and I just really wanted more from this story. But from that 3.25 rating, I ended up now boosting it to 3.5 because I still think about this book, and it's remained, you know, I still think about it. Sometimes I just sit down and I start thinking about this book. So it's definitely memorable for me. So I boosted it up to 3.5, and I would suggest it if you are interested in picking it up. And the next two things that I read here are Fuku Fuku Volume 1 and Volume 2. This manga is just about a kitten, and it's just daily life. And the owner is an elderly woman, and it's just really cute and really fun. And if you're looking for something light and fluffy, I would definitely suggest this. And from my knowledge, these are the only two published at the moment, and I don't think there's going to be any more. At least on Goodreads, it's only these two. So if you're interested in reading them, you only have to read two. So I would highly recommend them. They're really cute, and I gave them both 4 stars. Here I read The Gunslinger by Stephen King. This was a reread for me. I read it about last year around this time as well, but I reread it this month with my friend Rachel. So I'll have her channel link down below as well. This book is about a man in the desert, and he is trying to find the man in black, and we don't know why, but the gunslinger, and we follow the gunslinger in the desert and his journey and what's going on with him. I really reread this for the movie as well, so I can continue with the series because I don't remember much about this first book. I did like this better the second time around. It's still not my favorite King novel, and I still had some just issues with the plot and its pacing. Doing this one a lot better than the first time. Not a ton better, but I enjoyed it more, and I ended up giving it a 3.5 stars. And I'll have my video book review linked up on the screen and down below if you guys want to hear more of my thoughts. And the next book here that I read was On Writing by Stephen King. This is Stephen King's memoir about just his life and just advice about writing, and it was really good and really informative. I listened to the audiobook of this, so he actually narrated it. The book does have some trigger warnings, so it has trigger warnings for substance abuse and alcoholism. So if you are triggered by those things or affected by those topics, just keep that in mind before picking this book up. This was super informative and just a delight to read. It took me like the first quarter, I was like, oh, okay, but like I really got into it later, and I think if 100% if you're writing a book right now, this would help you a ton. So you should read this, and it was really good. And if you're a King fan, you'd also enjoy it. So I give this 4 stars, and I'd highly recommend it. The next book I have here is You're Doing Just Fine by Charlotte Erickson. And this book is a poetry collection. It's a collection of poetry, and it includes prose as well. I did do a review on this book as well, so I'll have that linked up on the screen. Basically, I was sent this by the author in exchange for an honest review, and I really, really enjoyed it, but I will state some trigger warnings now. So this book does have trigger warnings for addiction, depression, suicide, and mentions of self-harm, so keep that in mind before picking this book up. For me, this was really impactful for me, and it just meant a lot, and if you're into poetry, I'd highly recommend checking this one out. Give this book a 4.25 out of 5 stars. Everything Beautiful Is Not Yet Ruined by Daniel Young Elman, and this book was really good. It's a YA contemporary book. It's with suicide, depression, and sexual assault, but it's also, we go between past and present, and basically this girl, her mother was a famous opera singer, so the mom doesn't really believe in like that music is a good career, because it, like, even though she pulled it off for a while, it went downhill for her and it like broke her heart. So her daughter wants to go into music and her mom's really against it, but she says if you go to this outdoor wilderness survival camp, I'll let you go to your music school. So that's what she does, and it's about her past with her mom, and then we also follow her in her survival wilderness camp. This was a pleasant surprise for me. I think it was a great read, and if you're looking for a contemporary that's hard-hitting, I definitely suggest this one. I found myself absolutely enthralled by the story and this character and everything that was happening. The only issue was there was a few spoiler issues. I talk about that on Goodreads, so if you have read it, I'll have my Goodreads review linked down below and the little spoilery section that you could check out. But I ended up giving this book a solid 4 stars, and I'd highly recommend it. And yes, it was great. You should really read it. So those were the books that I read in the month of August. Let me know what you read down in the comments. And if you're new here, be sure to hit that subscribe button and click the notification bell to be updated for when I post new videos and all that sort of stuff. And I'll see you all very soon with a new video. Bye. March. Ow, I'm gonna break my neck.
Whatever you do in life will be insignificant. It's very important that you do it.